Ruined, limping vehicles filled with shaggy mouth, youthful gangsters hunting the human dog with stilettos of fear and dreams of money, sex, money, cars, money, suits, money, shoes, money, muscles, money, houses, money, hair, money, pearly teeth, money. Pointed shoes, money, hats, money, money, success grasped by money, gnarled hands of lanky editorial writers, false teeth, credit dentists, cheap meat, queer butchers, editorial chested bus drivers, eye shadow sales girls, all American football businessmen, hollow thighs, supermarket clerks, money, flag makers, money, mountain movers, money, car makers, money, money eyed raw material citizens, pulped of money, landscapes of holy money, time, musical voices of tiny money children. Cushion noises of disintegration still heard in dynastic eras of power skeletons stooped in scooped out offices of company wives, husbands, custodians of domestic fear and fear, terror for still harder heathen breathers lurking behind neo tombstones, singing out corpse voice arias while bristling beaks complain. Money, money. Historical events. Apollinaire never knew about Rock Gut Charlie, who gave 50 cents to a policeman driving around in a 1927 Nash. Apollinaire never met Cinder Bottom Blue, fat saxophone player who laughed while playing and had steel teeth. Apollinaire never hiked in papier-mâché woods and had a scoutmaster who wrote a song about ivory soap and had a Baptist funeral. Apollinaire never sailed with Riff Raff Rolf, who was rich in California but had to flee because he was queer. Apollinaire never drank with Lady Choppy Wine, peerless female drunk who talked to shrubs and made children sing in the streets. Apollinaire never slept all night in an ice house waiting for Sebastian to rise from the ammonia tanks and show him the little unpainted arrows. Heavy water blues. The radio is teaching my goldfish jujitsu. I'm in love with a skin diver who sleeps underwater. My neighbors are drunken linguists and I speak butterfly. Consolidated Edison is threatening to cut off my brain. The postman keeps putting sex in my mailbox. My mirror died and can't tell if I still reflect. I put my eyes on a diet. My tears are gaining too much weight. I crossed the desert in a taxi cab, only to be locked in a pyramid with the face of a dog on my breath. I went to a masquerade disguised as myself, not one of my friends recognized. I dreamed I went to John Mitchell's poetry party in my maiden form brain. Put the silver in the barbecue pit. The Chinese are attacking with nuclear restaurants. The radio is teaching my goldfish jujitsu. My old lady has taken up skin diving and sleeps underwater. I'm hanging out with a drunken linguist who can speak butterfly and represents the caterpillar industry down in Washington, D.C. I never understand other people's desires or hopes until they coincide with my own, and then we clash. I have definite proof that the culture of the caveman disappeared due to his inability to produce one magazine that could be delivered by a kid on a bicycle. When reading all those thick books on the life of God, it should be noted that they were all written by men. It is perfectly all right to cast the first stone if you have some more in your pocket. Television, America's ultimate relief from the Indian disturbance. I hope that when the machines finally take over, they won't build men that break down as soon as they're paid for. I shall refuse to go to the moon unless I'm inoculated against the dangers of indiscriminate love. After riding across the desert in a taxicab, he discovered himself locked in a pyramid with the face of a dog on his breath. The search for the end of the circle, constant occupation of squares. Why don't they stop throwing symbols? The air is cluttered enough with echoes. Just when I cleaned the manger for the wise men, the shrews from across the street showed up. The voice of the radio shouted, "Get up! Do something to someone!" But me and my son laughed in our furnished room. He had a great sense of humor, too. There's a lineage poem. "Afterwards, they shall dance. In the city of St. Francis, they've taken down the statue of St. Francis, and the hummingbirds all fly forward to protest, humming feather poems. Bodenheim denounced everyone and wrote, Bodenheim had no sweet marijuana dreams. Patriotic musculateer did not die seriously. No poet loved to end with gone. Dylan took the stone cat snap at St. Vincent's. That a canned beer, no defense. That poem shouted from nun-filled room, an insult to the brain's nerve saved now from Swansea, white horses, beer bird, snore, poems, whales, bird. Billie Holiday got lost on the subway and stayed there forever. Raised little peace of mind gardens in out-of-the-way stations and will go on living in wrappers of jazz silence forever, loved. My face feels like a living emotional relief mat, forever wet. My hair is curling in anticipation of my own wild gardening. Poor Edgar Allan Poe died translated in unpressed pants. Ended in light, surrounded by ecstatic gold bugs, his hegira blessed by Baudelaire's orgy. Whether I am a poet or not, I use $50 worth of air every day. Cool. In order to exist, I hide behind stacks of red and blue poems and open little sensuous parasols, singing the nail in the foot song, drinking cool beatitudes. Waiting, somewhere there waits, waiting. A book is waiting, waiting to be written. Cold, cold pages waiting to be written. Man sees God in a book. Somewhere there waits, waiting. A picture waits, waiting, waiting to be painted. Cold, cold canvas, canvas waiting to be painted. Man seeks God in a picture. Somewhere there waits, waiting. A woman waiting, waiting to be loved, waiting. Cold, cold woman waiting to be loved. Man seeks God in a woman. Somewhere there waits, waiting. A man is waiting, waiting. Cold, cold, cold man waiting to be wanted, waiting. Man seeks God in man. Somewhere there waits, waiting. A baby is waiting, 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 waiting to be born. Cold, cold baby waiting to be born. Blood of earth waiting to be. Man sees God in a baby. Wind, sea, stars, sky surround us. Wind, sea, wind, sky, wind, stars surround us. Wind, sea, sky, stars surround us. Sarasvati, may Sarasvati give thee intelligence entwined with the lotus. Thou art produced from limb by limb, but of the heart thou art born. Thou indeed are the self-called sun, so live 100 autumns. May Sarasvati give thee intelligence. Reflections on a Small Parade. When I see the little Buddhist scouts marching with their Zen mothers to sea, when I see the little Buddhist scouts marching with their Zen mothers to tea ceremonies at the rock garden, I shake my head, it falls off. And this is, he's called Chenrezig Walks With Us. Chenrezig, a Buddhist deity. Dalai Lama is an incarnation of Chenrezig, visualized with many arms. So this is a little mantra. swept away all suffering, gathered it up in a quantum leap, sucked it up till it returned. And when Chenezic looked back over his shoulder and saw all suffering come back in a great wave, all suffering suffering, riding in, filling up nooks and crannies and crevices and templates of the world, all suffering, filling neurons and quarks and leptons, troubling minds of mothers, sisters, brothers, fathers, lovers, all sentient beings, suffering, talking toxins of passion, aggression, ignorance in the middle of the night, strapped in demon mind, nowhere to hide, pounding, suffering rides in, and mind splits in a thousand pieces. Chenrezig wept, and head split in a thousand pieces, and mighty fire Buddha Amitabha leans in Amitabha, puts the puzzle back together, wires it with tantric thread, adds some extra arms, extra heads, a conglomeration of tendencies, this wisdom body to rid the world of all suffering. More arms and heads take charge, build it better, a deity to maximize power of bodhicitta to ease all suffering. And now Chenrezig had a thousand arms in all directions of space, a thousand arms with numerous accoutrements, and under those arms a thousand hearts better to banish all suffering, all suffering of Tibet, of India, suffering. Suffering of Pakistan, wherever his crystallized land, whatever map of suffering. Hallelujah lights on, Hallelujah lights on. Keep emptying Europe, USA empty, Israel, Palestine empty. China, Russia, Japan, 11 heads with 11 third eyes and more wisdom eyes in all the pores of his body. Chenrezig walks among us, humble prince toward all systems of empire. Chenrezig walks among us, all constituent forms, precious ink, diamond scepter, skull cup of blood, thigh bone trumpet, dissolve in mind, and lotus at his feet arises again through cracks of a concrete city or charnel grounds, eternal war. Star flowers shoot at dark of a distant galaxy, anywhere out of this world, his heart is that big, and Dharma gates are endless, he enters every one of them, typhoons and famines dissolve, emptiness has formed to come at you, blow back his love, his love come back at your multiverse, move in the night that never sets. Is it cold out there? Will Tibet be liberated on Judgment Day? Oh suffering, and we'll relight the butter lamp of the dark age. Banish, banish, banish the syndicates of samsara. Put away the checks of doom. Turn the wheel again in our frail world age. Oh, Chenrezig walks among us, and no identity endures. Yet bodhisattvas are ever active, invisible elves, swirling shamans, shape-shifting wizards, every hour dedicating the merit, no end time here, but aspiration to press harder. Don't tarry, don't tarry, don't tarry, don't tarry. Keep trying, sweep all suffering away, all pockets of the multiverse. Don't tarry, don't tarry, don't tarry. Bob was a Buddhist, too, a great spiritual poet.